California, USA Final Competition, and here are our contestants.
Thank you. UC Calabasas.
Courtney Patterson, Orange County.
Margaret Polis, Santa Claus County.
Michelle Cortez, the Stone Rock.
The amazing Keely Sanders. Can we give it up to Keely?
there's a little rumor going around. Okay. You know, you got a little bit more experience than me, so I'm kind of like the rookie with this whole pageant thing. This is my first time hosting, you know. So I just want to tell you, you know, I'm not used to being around this many fine girls at the same time. I mean, I'm the only one up here, and I'm with all these beautiful girls. So if I get nervous, just slow me down, give me a little nudge, and say, "Yo, Sam,
okay, I promise. I have to say, I think myself and most of the people in this room have a hard time believing that this is the first time you've been around a large group of beautiful women. But I promise I will keep you. I will keep you in line. I promise. And the reason is true. I might have a little bit of pageant experience, so.
Yeah, and I have to say, I think being Miss Teen USA is a little bit more than just a little bit of an experience.
Well, maybe a little, but I promise I won't leave you up here, and everything will be fine. You'll be fine.
Okay.
I got it. You'll be fine.
I'll hang in there.
Good. All right, well, I have to say, too, for Sam, I don't exactly think you are camera shy or new to the entertainment world. You have your show on MTV, Life as an Entertainer. Mm-hmm. And you have appeared in over 30 movies. And you travel around the world with your music and your movies and your show, everything.
Yeah.
So I have one question for you. What do you think of Palm Springs?
Well, I gotta be honest with y'all. See, I'm a pretty dark brother, and Palm Springs is hot. You know what I mean? So I've been burning up the last 3 days. And to be honest with you, I came here, I'm a host, I'm here to do a job, and I'm just focused. Even though there's like 500-600 girls running around, it's been about work. So I'm here in work mode and strictly work mode only. So Palm Springs has been awesome, but I've been focused.
I don't know if I totally believe you, but okay. But I have to say, my time here in Palm Springs, this is the first time that KQ Productions has brought the Miss California USA pageant to Palm Springs. And we could not be more thankful to the city. And I want to thank Mayor Odom, the entire city of Palm Springs, the Bureau of Tourism, the CDA, the Viceroy Hotel for housing all of our judges, and more than anyone, the amazing staff, everyone, David Sullivan, Rick Leeson, your entire staff, from housekeeping to catering to security to everyone here at our host, the Riviera Resort here in Palm Springs. So thank you so much, guys.
Well, I gotta be honest with you, Keely. I've seen you girls work really hard over the last couple of days, and I'm just really excited to see who made the top 15.
Well, it's a lot of hard work. I can tell you, not only are these women beautiful,
right,
and intelligent,
right,
and goal-oriented,
right,
but they are sleep-deprived,
right,
at this point. They are nervous,
right,
but I swear they're gonna be a fantastic tonight, and they're gonna do a fantastic job. So let's bring them out and let's find out who's gonna compete.
And before we do, I just wanna let you guys know, Saturday morning, each girl competed at a personal panel interview. And last night, they all competed in swimsuit and evening gown during the prelim competition. Each portion of the competition is weighted evenly. All three scores are combined, and the top 15 names will be announced shortly.
Right now? Bring them up.
Give it up for them. Come on, guys.
We are now ready to announce our top 15. We are now going to announce our first semi-finalist. We are now going to announce our second semifinal. We are now going to announce our second, third semifinalist. Here we go, our fourth semifinalist.
Miss City of Angels, USA!
Here's our fifth semifinalist.
Miss Los Angeles County, USA!
This is our sixth semifinalist.
Miss Fontana, USA!
This is our seventh semifinalist.
Miss La Mesa, USA!
This is our eighth semifinalist.
Miss Alliance Entertainment, USA!
We are now going to announce our ninth semifinalist.
Miss San Diego, USA!
We are now going to announce our 10th semifinalist.
Miss Chula Vista, USA!
We are now going to announce our 11th semifinalist.
Miss Ventura County, USA!
Our 12th semifinalist.
Miss Bay Area, USA!
We are now announcing our 13th semifinalist.
Miss Sacramento Valley, USA!
And now we will announce our 14th semifinalist.
Miss Palm Springs, USA!
And now we will announce our 15th semifinalist.
Miss Greater San Diego, USA!
Together, please. Before we go on, ladies and gentlemen, we ask for everybody to quiet for 1 minute. Quiet, please, for 1 minute. We believe we have an error in our announcement, and we're all fine. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your 15 semifinalists for the title of Miss California 2006. Thank you, ladies. Ladies, 5, 6, 7, go! Let's give a nice match round of applause for these incredible, beautiful, smart, fantastic contestants. We love you! Thank you, ladies.
California USA judge panel, and trust me guys, I am glad I'm not one of these judges, because this job here, you think it's hard being in the panel, being on the, with the
stage.
Girls, yeah, being in the panel is even harder, so you guys got a tough job tonight. Alright, now the first judge I want to introduce is Bob Hartingale. Growing up in Texas, home of more Miss USA than any other state, Bob developed a keen eye for pageants at an early age. Still with his strong interest in pageants, Bob works in the state capitol as chief of staff to Assemblyman Mark Leno of San Francisco. Also an avid athlete, Bob has competed in soccer tournaments and several continents and is an accomplished marathon runner. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Bob Hartingale. Now, judge number two, Gail Means. A much sought-after casting director, she's worked with some of the most famous names in the business. You can see her discoveries in the pages of GQ, Harper's Bazaar, Vogue, and In Style. Her client list includes household names as Max Factor and Target. Gail is a graduate of the Art Center College of Design and calls Southern California home. Ladies and gentlemen, can we please give it up for Gail Means?
Valerie Trott. A powerhouse in the modeling and fashion world, Valerie began her career managing Vidal Sassoon, first American salon. She quickly moved into the world of modeling and put models such as Rene Russo, Cheryl Teague, and Lisa Taylor on magazine covers across the world. Later, she became the president of Elite Los Angeles, and in 1999, she co-founded her own agency, Champagne Trott. She currently works as a consultant around the country for fashion and modeling. Valerie Trott.
Give it up.
Judge number four is Bob Reed. Bob is half of the executive duo for NBC's The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. He is responsible for booking stand-up comedians for the show, and he is one of the founders of HBO Original Programming and HBO Pictures. He has acted as a consultant for the last two seasons on Bravo's hit series Celebrity Poker, and has returned for a second series of NBC's hit stand-up reality comedy series, The Last Comic Standing. Ladies and gentlemen, Bob Reed.
Judge number five, Stella Stokler. Not only is she an icon in the pop culture business, she's also the muscle behind booking talent for one of my favorite stations, VH1's Biggest Event. As an executive producer, Stella has taken us further inside the world of celebrity than anyone ever dared to go. With Inside Out, Joey Pants, and ooh, girl, you worked with Toni Braxton? Toni Braxton. In short, if it's hot, trust me, guys, Stella knows it. Ladies and gentlemen, Stella Stokler!
All right now, guys, so check it out. This is when things get really intense. I know it's hard, but this time for my favorite part of it, the swimsuit. I know each of these ladies has been working really hard, because you guys know what it's like. When it's summertime, you want to show everything. So these girls have been in the gym,
They've been working out with Arnold Schwarzenegger, doing their thing. So now it's time to show, you know, what they got. So without further delay, it's time to introduce my favorite portion of the competition, the 2006 Miss California, Miss USA Swimsuit Competition. See what they got.
Nico Nash, Miss North Los Angeles, USA, 25.
Miss Tyra Collin, Miss Northridge, USA, 21.
Ashley Coleman, Miss Hollywood Hills, USA, 24.
Andrea Mullen, Miss City of Angels, USA.
Lacey Wilson, Miss Los Angeles County, USA, 21.
Megan Tandy, Miss Montana, USA, 20.
Stathoulis, Miss La Mesa, USA, 25.
Amy Holland, Miss Alliance Entertainment USA, 21.
Lindley Walsh, Miss San Diego, USA, 25. Tiffany McCollum, Miss Sacramento Valley, USA, 21.
Vanessa Sierra, Miss Palm Springs, USA, 22.
Thank you. that's not me, is all I have to say.
Oh, please, you know you would look good in one of those bathing suits.
No, let's not go But these girls, let's talk about the girls and what they've been doing this weekend. Because though I said they're sleep deprived, and it's been a jam-packed weekend for them, they just got here on Friday morning.
Right.
And we've done all of this. They've competed in three areas. And now we're already done with our first competition with the finalists. I can't believe it's gone by that fast. But I have good news. You can buy all these memories and take them home with you.
Oh, now that's incredible.
That now, I'm sure a lot of you already have your program books. If not, they are available in the lobby. And you're in the program book.
I'm
all the contestants are in the program book. All
yeah.
the sponsors are in the program book. The city's in the program book. The hotel, everyone. So it's a really great memory to have. But that's not all.
What else, Julie?
If everybody's noticed, we have all these cameras around.
Oh, so cameras mean we might be
video. There you go. Absolutely.
Wait, Keeley, before you go on, and all you parents out there, I just want to tell you guys and encourage you guys, please get the video, because no disrespect, these girls are beautiful, but one day they're going to be really old, like 90, 100 years old. And you know, every woman wants to be able to tell their kid, honey, at one time, your mama was the bomb, okay? So go ahead and get you them videotapes. So it's not just talk. She got backup, right? So fellas, are you with me? Dig into your wallet.
They hold up pretty well. I don't think I've done so bad for 10 years.
Keely, talk to me in about 70 years.
Well, regardless, the videos are fun to have. You can get them with both shows or with one show, but also available in the lobby. And you'll also be able to get them on the Miss California USA website after the show. But there's even more.
More?
More.
More.
We also have our official Miss California USA photographer, Uta Villa. And she's also in the program book and all the photos from the entire weekend. So we are talking 3 days of events will be available on her website, which is utavillaphotography.com. And like I said, still on the program book, so they can buy that and they can just reference all they want. Also, there will be a link from the Miss California USA. So it's a great way to have memories for the rest of their life. I still have my tapes.
Do you really?
Tapes, pictures. My mother loves to pull them out.
You don't show them to your kids yet, huh?
No,
you don't have any.
I don't have any children.
All right, we'll keep them in the archives. It's in the future.
Okay. Now, I have to bring up someone at this time. This is a whole group of amazing ladies up here, and we all agree on that in this room. But there is another amazing lady.
Oh, Keely, don't do it to me. Don't.
And I know you're a fan.
Don't do it to me, Keely.
She has worn the crown and held the title for the past year. So I want to bring up now Miss Brittany Hogan, the 2005 Miss California USA.
Fine. Come on.
I think Sam's starting the official Brittany Hogan fan club.
No, can I tell him my little story real quick?
Yes.
Okay,
the story is funny.
Just
I'll
real quick, I'm not trying to brag or anything, but I'm an actor and I've worked with a lot of beautiful women, Pamela Anderson, Beyonce, whatever. And I met Brittany and her family yesterday. And guys, you guys know what I'm talking about. Brittany was talking to me, and seriously, this girl was so fine. Like, I was just like, I didn't even know what to say. And then the best part, Brittany's grandmother. This lady was 82 years old, feeling on my six-pack, talking about, ooh, I like that chocolate. Now, that's the type of girl I'm looking for. Where's Grandma? She didn't come today? Where is she? She's here?
She's here?
Grandma,
right
stand
here.
Up!
There we go!
Oh, that's my girl right there! That is my girl!
You're just going to move right into the Hogan family.
I am.
I think that might be his plan.
I know.
I'm trying to.
I told him I got a kiss this time. I've come on stage 4 times. This is the first time I got a kiss.
Oh, well, it's a family show, you two. So it's a family show. But, Brittany, I want to talk about your year. You have made not only us, and I know Carolee Munger, who is your director, but you have made K2 Productions, the entire state of California, everyone, so proud of you. First runner-up at Miss USA this year. And I know it's been an exciting year for you. You've been school and work and pageant. I really don't know how you've done it all, but tell us a little bit about the year and your experience at Miss USA and all of that.
Oh, that's a lot. You should have been a couple of things. But this year has been, let me tell you, one of the most amazing years of my entire life. I've made some incredible international. Usually, let me tell you too. Usually, I'm extremely articulate. Ask my mom. I can talk for hours and hours. Right now, the words are it's a struggle to get them out. But it was a great year. I no regrets. Couldn't have asked God for anything more gracious than the gift that He gave me. It really was one of the most incredible years of my life.
So, tell me some of the things that you've done with your title. I know you've had a lot of speaking opportunities and extravagant appearances and all of that. So.
Okay, one of my highlights would have been competing on Fear Factor. Definitely fun.
Did anyone
and
see this girl in the tank? With me, what was it? Fish oil and worms?
Two worms and some fish. Yeah.
First runner up.
Okay, 3 seconds away from $50,000.
Oh.
No, it was great. I just came back from Tennessee. I was at the St. Jude Children's Hospital fundraiser. It was a big fashion show. Great weekend. I actually got to rejoin a lot of the girls I had competed against out at Miss USA. So it was a lot of fun. Just experiences that I wouldn't have done otherwise. I was able to go all through California from San Francisco to San Diego. Did a lot with schools, speaking about character counts and character education, the importance of instilling values and morals in a child. Spoke at a ton of churches. It was great. What can I say? I've been totally blessed.
Now wait a minute. I know, Brittany, you're incredible, but I have one more quick Brittany story, not because I'm in love with her or anything. But yesterday I met Brittany's whole family. You have what, 8 brothers and
Tristan,
sisters?
Tristan, come here.
He got, because this is the story right here. I'm sorry, guys. I got to do this. Tristan, get up here. So yesterday I meet Brittany's mom, her dad, grandma, everybody, and we're all hanging out. And I meet her little brother, Tristan. And there's something about me, I don't know what it is. I get along with all kids, and me and kids is just, it's like the most amazing thing. So me and Tristan are hanging out. I'm talking to the family, and he keeps poking me. So he's like, and I'm talking to his sister, so I ain't even paying attention to him. So all of a sudden, he gets my attention, and I'm like, what's up, man? What, little man?
You remember what you told Sam last night when you poked him? It would be really cool.
There's a lot of pressure, you two.
I'll tell him what he said. So he looks at me like a grown-up, okay? Now, this kid is 5 years old. He looks at me like a grown-up, and he's poking me, and he goes, Sam, you know what would be really cool? I'm like, what? If you became my brother-in-law.
What?
Yes! So check it out. I'm a smart man. I got mom in the house, dad in the house. I'm like, you see what your son said? You know kids know best, right?
He retold that story again and again and
Let's
again.
Let's give
and
it
again.
Up for Tristan. Can
yeah.
we give it up? Can I get a high five? Yeah! That's the real future stars right there.
Sam, I think you should be ashamed of yourself. You really shouldn't bribe a 5-year-old.
No, I didn't even pay him nothing. For real. The
I
kid
don't
knew
you.
That I would be a good man for his sister.
Well, now you did. You talked a little bit about Miss USA, but you spent 2.5 weeks?
Almost three weeks
in Baltimore, Maryland, competing for Miss USA, which is a super fun but super exhausting and exciting 2 weeks. So 3 weeks.
I
tell us about that.
Every emotion out in Maryland. I was happy. I was excited. I wanted to put my hat on and catch the first plane to get back to California. I experienced a range of emotions, and we probably averaged about 3 hours of sleep a night. I'm sure you remember that.
I remember. Yes, Miss Teen USA, they know I competed.
Give it up!
No, this is about you!
So Keely knows. You average about 3 hours sleep a night. You wake up, you have the black circles underneath your eyes are bloodshot, and then you're expected to walk out and smile and wave and meet media that's never met you before and have a bright light shining in your face saying, hi, I'm from California. So that was probably the most nerve-wracking of the entire experience. Other than that, unbelievable again. Grew a ton for that challenge. Didn't think I could make 3 weeks in Maryland. Made it. Came in first runner-up. Experience of my life.
So,
well, we are so proud of you. You have to know that.
I just want to ask something, you know, just for the fellas out there. Now that you're big time, not for me, for the guys out there, now that you're big time and you're doing it big and you're not going to be so busy doing everything next year, what are you looking for in a man? For a man to lock you down, I mean, what are you looking for?
He already did her interview portion.
Yeah, I thought he tried this last show.
What are you looking for?
He
still trying.
You know what? I'm not looking for a relationship right now. And I'll share something with
perfect.
The crowd.
Perfect.
No, I'll share something with the
okay.
crowd.
Okay.
I'm not looking to get married.
No, the next big step in my life is coming up in January. And I will be flying to London and overnighting a few nights and then flying on. Then I'm flying to Africa.
Yeah, Sue, we are meant to dad. You hear this?
This is what he's
going to Africa.
That's why I held off on this story.
Come on.
So then I'm flying to Africa. I'll be living in Africa for 6 months in Uganda. Well, Mom, Dad, I know I haven't told you this yet, but surprise.
Well, the state of California is going to miss you, but I have to bring up someone else now. Not only are we lucky enough to work with one title holder every year, we get to work with two title holders. And in the pageant industry, I will say, they're kind of known as the little sister. And it's a very, very special relationship. It's a very important relationship. You understand what each other's going through. It's good to bounce things off each other and be supportive. So I would like to bring out now our, she just gave up her title, but Stephanie Brink, who shared her year with Brittany.
Get out here, Stephanie!
Miss California Teen USA 2005. Actually were there in Maryland to see Brittany become first runner-up.
It was my privilege to be in Baltimore in the middle of April with my father, watching Brittany, screaming my lungs out. I was on the floor, freaking out. And she did so well. She made California proud. She made us proud. Just like she does all year.
Why don't you two share some stories about your year? I know you guys have traveled together quite a bit.
Sharing the year with somebody where you can pull back memories there and experienced it with you. My family, for example, a great support. And Stephanie, having someone with you that you can lean on when you're getting tired and encourage you and be there with you, it's worth everything. So that's definitely why they were smart enough to come up with a Miss California and a Miss California.
I want to ask you something. Now, after you won your title, you know, sometimes girls can play a Hagen and can be a little bit jealous and catty. What was it like at school? Because, you know, for me last year when I won Mr. Africa, people have not been treating me the same since then. So I want to know, for you, did it change your life? How did people react to you, especially girls? Yes.
That's a good question. And being in high school, I think those things.
Stephanie was not only, I'm going to interrupt you for one moment, not only did she carry the title all year, but it was also her senior year of high school. So we all know how busy that can be.
It was a lot to handle. Going back to the first question, I didn't wear this to school, so most of the girls didn't know about my title and go to a pretty small school, but you know, my community was so supportive and
so they were cool.
Encouraged me. Yeah, they were very proud of me and supported me and loved me the whole time. So, and you know, I'm still the same girl.
She's so sweet. How could anyone be mean to her, right?
And Stephanie was fourth runner-up to Miss Teen USA, so we're all so proud of
her. That's big. That's big.
California did well this year, and you are going to Africa, and you are going to college.
That's right. I moved in last week. So.
She has class tomorrow morning and has not done her homework, right?
That's true. I'm sorry to say.
We are so proud of both of you, and we are so honored to spend this year with you. And I know we're going to all stay in touch, and we will be excited to hear all about your Africa travels and all about college. So, ladies, thank you so much.
I personally too want to say thank you. Brittany and I have been especially blessed this past year. We got the best of both worlds. Carolee Munger and staff, we love you to death, and we thank you for everything. And Keith and Keely, you have stepped alongside us also and been totally available for us, and we really, really appreciate that.
Well, thank you, girls. Awesome. We are honored to work with both of you. Thank you.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you.
done hearing from us. Yes. And I believe we have the top 10.
Oh, we do?
We do.
Cool.
So we are going to bring out the top 15, and we will move on to the top 10 finalists.
Let's get it going. Give them a round of applause. Come on. Cheer them on. Let's go.
California.
number 8. Our 10 finalists. In the evening, our final competition, Miss California 2006.
Look good or what in those gowns. Makes me want to go to prom all over again. I'm serious. They looked amazing, man.
Well, there's a new reaction to evening gown. I like it, though. I like it. Well, I can't believe that there's only one more competition left before we have a new Miss California USA.
Only one more and we're
out of here. I know. The whole weekend. But it's exciting. We're going to have a brand new Miss California USA.
Yeah. Whole new adventure ahead of her.
Absolutely, but you know what?
What?
Just a couple hours ago, we crowned a brand new Miss California Teen USA.
Yes, we did.
And
Give
we
it
would
up.
Like to bring her up on stage. Where is our brand new Miss California Teen
Where
USA,
are you?
Jessica Powell? Here Where? She is.
There she is. Give it up for Jessica Powell, guys.
Has it sunk in yet?
No, absolutely not. I probably won't until tomorrow
morning
when I wake up and realize this is a dream.
Well, we are so excited. So tell us a little bit about how you prepared and about the weekend and coming and how you're feeling and all that stuff.
Well, how I prepared, I hit the gym. I was working really hard in the gym. I got a personal trainer and everything because I knew I really wanted to look good for this competition. And the whole weekend was so much fun. My roommate was amazing. I couldn't have asked for a better roommate. I've had a lot of fun. I can't even think how to put it into words right now. Everything's so overwhelming. I'm just so excited, and I can't wait for the year.
Now, you held the title of Miss Barstow Teen USA. Is that where you're from?
Yes, I'm from Barstow. It's a very small town. There's about...
Represent Barstow in the house!
Barstow's very proud. I heard they already know.
Yeah, I have about 30.
tells everybody right afterwards.
We all have that aunt.
We all got that aunt.
That's fantastic, though. So how old are you, and are you, what year are you in high school?
I'm 17, and I just started my senior year at
You're gonna have to get some advice from Stephanie on how to juggle that senior year and Miss California Teen USA. Yeah. It's gonna be a big year for you.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm so excited.
And you will compete for Miss Teen USA in August.
Yes, I'm very excited.
On NBC.
The whole town of Barstow will be there. I know it. Because Barstow is so supportive. And whenever something big happens to somebody who lives in Barstow, they're all right there supporting us. So I love Barstow. I love you guys.
What school are you at?
What's your high school?
Barstow High School. The only high school we have.
Everything is Barstow. Barstow shoes, Barstow food. Everything is Barstow out there.
I understand. I'm a small town girl myself, so.
I got a Barstow watch. That ain't a Rolex, that's a Barstow.
Look at him making fun of small town girls.
No, I love
Barstow.
I don't
see a TR on your head.
Hey, no, you know what? Without Barstow, though, I'll be in trouble because whenever I'm going to Vegas, you know you need that quick snack. Come on now. You know you need that snack. You know you need gas. So I got number love for y'all, Barstow. Seriously. Give it up for Barstow. Come on. Give it up. Yeah.
Well, that's what Barstow's famous for, getting your gas. And it's more than just tumbleweed. So if you ever have an extra weekend, drive down and call me. I'll get you a tour.
Well, that's an invitation. Well, we are so excited for the year ahead. Keith and I and the entire K2 production staff is so excited to get to know you and your family and everyone much better throughout the year and prepare you for Miss Teen USA. So everyone, keep your eye on Jessica. You will see her on NBC come August.
Big.
Thank you so much.
Give it up for Jessica, y'all. Represent Barstow!
And we're ready.
We're ready?
We have the top five.
Woo! That's what I've been waiting for, yeah!
This is it. Let's bring the ladies out.
Let's bring our ladies out as we announce our five finalists for the title of Miss California 2006. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we will announce the first finalist. Here we go, our second finalist.
Miss Chula Vista, USA!
Now we will announce our third finalist. Our fourth finalist.
Miss North Los Angeles, USA!
Well, here we go, we're announcing our fifth finalist. Ladies and gentlemen, your five finalists for the title of Miss California 2006. One who will be our new Miss California USA.
Yeah!
Congratulations, ladies, and we have one more round of competition, which This is my favorite portion of the competition. This is where we get to hear all of the ladies speak and get to know just maybe a little bit more about them. So I'm going to bring out Stephanie Brink.
Yeah.
One more time.
Give it up for Stephanie, guys.
One more time. Now each one of these ladies is going to draw a judge's name out of the bowl, and then that judge will ask you a question. So let's start with Ms. Fontana. Judge number two, Gail Means.
Hi there. Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
In 5 years, I see myself successful. I'd like to end film production and cheerleading, and I'm actually working on getting the Christian Youth All-Star Cheerleading Team started. And I see that getting off the ground, and I don't see myself married yet. I just see myself going towards my career in acting and modeling.
Miss Chula Vista, USA. Okay, you chose judge number one, Bob Hartnagle.
Hi there.
Hi.
What is one of the biggest problems facing your local community, and what should be done about it?
Well, I live in Chula Vista, which is a part of San Diego County, and San Diego County has become one of the more expensive counties to live in California. So I would have to say that the cost of affordable housing for local San Diegans and for local Californians has become a big problem, because we want people born and raised who have been Californians all their lives having to move out of state because they can no longer afford to live in such a great city. I would say affordable housing. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will take one final look at each contestant. Finalist number one. Number two.
Thank you. Finalist number three. Thank you. Finalist number four. Give out some awards. Thank you.
Thank you to all of the ladies here tonight. One more round of applause for Woo! All of the ladies.
Give it up for
them. And, really, now the ladies can relax a little bit because the competition is over.
Everyone can breathe at this point. Competition is over. Can you believe it?
Man, you know, it's been 3 days of hard work and lifelong dream, but you guys are all winners for me.
Absolutely.
You all fine.
And you know who else is taking?
All of them.
You know who else? It takes not just these girls, but the parents,
yeah.
The family.
Yeah. You know what? Yeah. You know what? Kelly's right. Can we have all the parents stand up?
Goal, but they've got a lot more to accomplish, and I know that's going to happen. But right now, before we get to the main event, okay. We have a few awards to hand out.
Ooh.
So, the first award, Sam, as a face of Tommy Hoag's figure for, was it 6 years?
Yeah, but who's counting?
You're counting, I know
it was
you.
It was a couple of years.
We're going to hand out Miss Photogenic.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, cool. That's a good one. This award was chosen by our official photographer, Uta Villa, and other modeling and acting industry professionals. And this year, Miss California USA, Miss Photogenic, is Andrea Mullins, Miss City of Angel.
Okay, we're skipping one of the awards. I was confused for a minute. Okay, now this award is really special because it's chosen by the contestants.
So this award is for Miss Congeniality, and this award goes to Jennifer Fitzgerald from
Long Beach. Where you at, Jennifer? Long Beach.
Congratulations.
Okay, now we have another special award.
All right, what's
and this
one?
Award is even extra special.
Okay.
This is the People's Choice Award, and many of you out there voted for this award. This award was voted on by audience members and people attending this weekend, and everyone bought a vote. And the entire Miss Universe organization, all the state directors, because this event takes place in every single state and District of Columbia, how we get the 51 girls come national. And every state is going to do this People's Choice Award, and all of the benefits go to the American Red Cross and to the victims of Hurricane Katrina.
Oh, that's awesome. Let's give it up for that. So I want to personally thank you guys for donating.
Absolutely, absolutely. And you know, it seems that people really get behind a cause, but I just want to remind everyone that this lot, so many of those families, we were just in New Orleans and Baton Rouge for Miss Teen USA. And New Orleans was such an amazing place, and we had such a great time, and it's filled with so many wonderful people that we just need to remember to keep giving as this goes on, because they have a lot of repair to do there. So the American Red Cross is going to be a huge help to all of them.
And it really just, you know, puts life in perspective.
Absolutely.
At the end of the day, it really does.
Absolutely. So this year's People's Choice Award goes to Lacey Wilson, Miss Los Angeles County, USA.
Down to this.
Well, we're being told to stretch a little. So.
Stretch? Oh, okay. Man, I get shy when
stretch?
We have to
no.
stretch. So, hasn't it been a great pageant, though, guys? It's been amazing, huh?
Now, let's talk about Sam.
Huh?
You and I get to stand up here, and we get to look like we're running the show.
Okay.
We're not.
No.
This production... And I just want to take a moment, not just from you and I, but from me and my entire K2 Productions and all of us here and all of these girls. We have an entire production staff of camera and food and hotel and housing and housekeeping and lights and sound and all of the house mothers that
Bill.
Keep track of all of these girls and all weekend long, these girls are very well taken care of. These house moms become their moms
they
for
do.
The weekend,
they
and
really
and you know we keep each one of these girls safe and sound, and so we're really excited. We're honored to have every single one of them on stage, and I hope they have had as great of a time this weekend as we have had getting to know each and every one of them. So
we do. Chris Rock is here.
Special guest.
Will Smith is here.
We have a lot of special guests, even if they're not in the audience. I want to personally thank the Miss Universe organization. The president of the Miss Universe organization, Paula Sugart, is here.
What's up?
Stand up. And next to her is Phil Gern from NBC. And the one that I talk to almost every day on the phone, Trisha Langa, is also here as the director of domestic licensing.
Yeah.
And also, Keith and I have been very blessed this year. This is our first year as directors. This is Keith Lewis over here. You saw him earlier in the evening.
Keith!
But we want to make sure that everybody knows how thankful we are. We had a lot of our fellow directors come in to support us. But there is one other man here that I really, really must say thank you to, because his city has blessed us and has been so amazing to us. The mayor of Palm Springs,
wow.
Mayor Odin, I want to thank you so much. Please stand up.
Big mayor.
We hope that... that Palm Springs is the home of Miss California for many years to come. You have such a beautiful, glamorous, welcoming city. We feel it's the perfect place, so we hope it's here for many years to come.
Definitely.
Okay, it's time.
It's time?
Yay, are you guys ready?
She's like, okay,
yeah!
I'm ready.
You know what we have to do first?
What we gotta do first?
There is one more thing. I have one very special lady backstage that has served this title for a year, and these are her last few moments as Miss California USA.
Oh, well, we gotta do it.
We have to say goodbye. So I would like everyone to please put your hands together for the beautiful Brittany Hogan, Miss California USA 2005.
Yeah! Where's she at? Give it up for her.
Okay, now it's time to announce. All right. Here we go. The fourth runner-up for the title of Miss California USA 2006 is Miss Fontana.
The third runner-up is Miss Hollywood Hills. This is it, guys.
Our second runner-up, Miss Sacramento Valley, USA. Now I have one quick, before we finish, if for any reason the winner cannot fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will be named Miss California USA 2006. And I also must say, if you are the winner's parent, family, or sponsor, please come to the stage as soon as we make the announcement for photographs. Right. Now that's all we're going to say, I promise.
Come on, Kiwi, I can't wait. Come on. Okay, guys. The first runner-up, Miss Chula Vista. And the winner is Miss USA North.